Incredicoaster at Disney California Adventure is a very famous and photogenic ride, and it is a lot of people's first looping coaster. But how is the ride like now? In this review, I'll be telling you my full thoughts on the whole ride experience. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8! This coaster had a pretty long history. It opened with the park as California Screamin' on February 8, 2001. The roller coaster was built to look like a classic wooden coaster, but it is made out of all steel. Disney California Adventure wasn't the most popular park, so they did many things to Paradise Pier to make it appeal more. On its second lift though, there used to be a Mickey Mouse shape, but then it got changed to a sun, with the words Paradise Pier on it. When California Screamin' first opened, it was the fourth longest roller coaster in the world at 6,072 feet of track. Just think about that for a second. The scream tubes were built for noise restrictions as the Paradise Pier Hotel was built nearby. But in 2017, the park announced to retheme almost all of Paradise Pier to Pixar Pier. Multiple rides will be transformed to be Pixar themed. Mickey's Fun Wheel is now Pixar Pal Around, and California Screamin' was rethemed to Incredicoaster. The layout itself never changed, but the theming around it did. The scream tubes were changed from blue to red, and there is some theming in the tunnels. There are multiple sections on the ride where there is more theming than the original California Screamin'. The ride experience did change a lot. So I rode this ride a total of 4 times. 2 times as California Screamin' and 2 times as Incredicoaster. I don't remember my rides as California Screamin' very well, so this is focused more on Incredicoaster. This ride was my first looping coaster, so it was very big for me. And before I went to Knott's, this was the most extreme coaster I've ever ridden. Now that I've visited Knott's a couple of times, I've started to depreciate this ride. I personally think it's a family thrill coaster. There are certain sections of the ride that are forceful, but overall it's not that intense. First of all, before you begin your ride experience, this ride is beautiful. This is one of the most aesthetically pleasing roller coasters out there. Incredicoaster combined with Pixar Pal Around by the water is stunning. Unfortunately, the lighting was too bad for me to take pictures, but I got a good one at night. So you begin your ride experience by going through the entrance plaza where you walk under the arc. The ride has a regular queue, a fast pass, and a single rider line. For the single rider line, you don't go through the arc to get there. There's a separate line that is labeled single rider line. But this ride has really good capacity. The trains seat 24 riders per train, and I believe 5 trains can run on this ride. So I didn't mind waiting in the regular line because it was only a 55-minute wait and it moved quickly. It also had some decent theming. This ride is themed to the Pixar movie Incredibles 2, and the storyline is that they asked Edna to babysit Jack-Jack, and he uses his unpredictable powers to escape. So during the ride, you are finding Jack-Jack. Pretty interesting storyline. This ride has a dual loading station, and I believe if you're in the single rider line, you have to go up and down elevators just to get to the correct side of the station. It's a very interesting system, I think. Be warned that this ride has assigned seating, but if you can, I think the back row is the best place to go on this ride. You board your Incredibles themed trains and pull down your over-the-shoulder restraints. Now I know that this ride could be better with the lap bar, but I think since this is a lot of people's first coaster to go upside down, they might feel more confident with over-the-shoulder restraints, so I'm not really complaining there. You start your incredible ride experience by taking an S-Bahn out of the station. You turn to your left while looking at a station, then notice that Jack-Jack is gone as you approach the launch track, waiting until dash counts in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then you launch, going from 0 to the ride's maximum speed of 55 miles per hour in 4 seconds. I thought that this launch was okay, it wasn't anything too special. Then you go through your first tunnel where you get a good pop of airtime. I wasn't expecting that from this ride. Then you drop and go into your first of 5 mid-course brake runs. And then you go into a very graceful turn. I didn't find much force on it at all, but it's pretty scenic. And then you turn to the left and go up the lift hill. It does use LSMs, but it feels like a lift hill, so I'll stick to calling it a lift hill. Then you go down the main drop on the ride. No height of this ride is found, but it has a drop height of 108 feet. I thought this drop was much better in the back than in the front. And then you do another graceful turn, another mid-course breaker, and then you go into the only inversion on the ride, a vertical loop. This loop for some reason had this really annoying vibration that I wasn't a big fan of, but the rest of the ride I thought was smooth. and then you go into yet another mid-course brake run with the tunnel. I think this tunnel is my favorite out of the three tunnels because you have this really cool purple effect while going through it. And then you go into another graceful turn, which, like the previous ones, doesn't give much force at all. And then you go into yet another mid-course brake run. I heard that this mid-course brake run is the best out of the five, but I thought they felt the same. And then you drop and go into two airtime hills. I thought they gave weak floater airtime, but the ride is going pretty slow through this by now. And then you go into your last mid-course brake run and go into a helix. I thought this helix provided some force, and this is also where you have your on-ride camera. And then you go into the brakes and pass through another scene, ending your ride on Incredicoaster. In total, the ride lasts for 2 minutes and 36 seconds. What I love about California Screamin' was how simple and beautiful it was. There are certain patches of the ride that I could tell Disney neglected, but overall the ride was beautiful and very photogenic. Also, the on-ride soundtrack it had was my favorite on-ride soundtrack of all time. Now as Incredicoaster, I think the soundtrack isn't as good. What I do like about Incredicoaster is the water effect while you're going on the first launch. You don't feel it at all, but it's great for off-ride. I like the theming in the tunnels as you get something to look at while you're in the tunnel. When you go through the last two airtime hills, you can see Jack-Jacks on sticks, which I thought was pretty interesting. Like I mentioned earlier, this ride is smooth except for the vertical loop. Some rattles I think can help the ride, but in this case, not so much. I found it to be annoying, but didn't take away from the overall ride experience. If you're expecting big thrills from this ride, then you won't get it. This ride isn't very forceful, and the airtime isn't the best. I'd say the best airtime moment is on the first Camelback after the launch. Expect mild thrills. This is a ride that definitely tries to introduce younger riders and families to different aspects a roller coaster can have, like a launch, bank turns, positive G's, lift hill, drop, vertical loop, airtime hills, and a helix. I see many of my GP friends doing their Be Brave challenges on this ride. It's a really great way to get people into coasters, and that included me as well. So while this ride isn't the most thrilling or the most intense, it's nevertheless still very fun and a great way to get people into coasters. That is my review of Incredicoaster at Disney California Adventure. Let me know down in the comments what are your thoughts on Incredicoaster, whether you've ridden it or not. Do you like the renovation, or do you still prefer it as California Screamin'? If you enjoyed this video, then please leave a like. I really appreciate it. Also, thanks to Coaster Source and DLAN SMK for providing some of the footage used in this video. And if you're new to this channel and roller coasters are what you're into, then please consider subscribing for content all about roller coasters. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you next time.